getting it happening. But it was right at that point, and then so I didn't know what to do. If you were one of the and that was another, like, I was talking to the captain for 6 months. I'm like, this may or may not be the first problem. Her mom voice was on.
Oh, I heard her talking the entire time.
Yeah, fine. No, I just feel like you were there for it. Dylan was here. You got like 6:30.
Oh, yeah, that conversation, though. I'm not sure. Yeah. Dylan's out.
70. He's like, you know, man, I'm 3 or 4 seconds. But the funniest part about it, because there was like a seat next to me, like, you want one? And she goes, no!
Like, just disappointed.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. I'm just disappointed. Thank you.
serious in the game.
I have enough people.
ANC North is gnarly right now.
Seems too much. So I was getting like almost so good. I'm like,
So, I pulled it out, put on the inbox on it. They're giving it, they put in this location.
It seems like it.
Which is, I thought it was like 32 or something.
They're trying to get rid of the car, yeah.
The ETS is a dumpster fire.
If you want to manipulate it and work it with this, what I thought was funny though, like when I was doing my ETS stuff here and I was trying to get my dairy stuff set up, you got down to the front of the front of the dairy stuff was due.
I don't even mean ETS, like the program, like software-wise. I mean like the entire process.
Oh yeah.
That's the best part.
What was even more?
This makes no sense.
And that's what I mean by the process.
This makes no sense. I was like, whatever I'm saying is authorized in there, you're approved. But my orders mean nothing if someone got to get there.
You know how many times when we still had like ATRAV and T-PACs and risk, you know how many times I showed up to an airport and I didn't have a ticket even though I thought I did? Never had, right? It's happened multiple times since ETS. It's because of all the ridiculous red tape, whatever you want to call it, multiple levels of authorization that need to happen before something gets ticketed or purchased. And back in the day, they just gave you orders and treat you like a big boy. They're like, you know what's authorized. If you buy something that's not authorized, guess what? You're paying for it. That's it. That's all it was. And you just called that truck and you're like, hey, I need a hotel, I need a car, I need a flight. Boom, boom, boom. Everything paid for right away. Right on your car, good to go. No, I don't even know how. Think about my time with the strike team. I don't know how they can operate these days with the way it is.
You guys got to go in hours.
Yeah, I got a call one time.
You got to go back.
For Harvey, I got a call Saturday night. I was leaving Sunday morning.
There used to be a traffic.
Within 12 hours. And it was at nighttime. Nobody was in the office. Yeah, exactly. It was just like, okay, cool. I drove to Ace the next morning. I hopped into the GV with the NKC. We hooked up the floodplain trailer and we left. That was it. You know, it was like, I don't even understand how you can do that these days. Like, they just, you know. Now, granted, we were driving, but, you know, tack on a plane flight to that. Like, that's, I don't know how it works anymore, you know, the way we used to do it. No YNs are in the office on the weekends, really. And rightfully so, they shouldn't have to be. You know what I mean? I'm not even saying that's a bad thing. I'm just saying, without them in there, or SKs, or whoever it is, like, how does the whole system, it just collapses Saturday and Sunday?
Right.
You know, like, I don't get it. I've gotten better with the system.
I
just tried to do my waiver voucher last night for October 1st through 17th, our, you know, the last one,
And it was like, that exceeds the maximum amount of zero. I'm like, I already got paid out for it. Either way, it's like a $2,700 voucher.
Oh, it's a change the account, right?
Yeah, it's 25. So it exceeds the maximum amount of zero. 0.0. I'm like, okay, well, I'm going to send Kenny a text.
Okay.
Yeah.
I,
Kenny Beers.
My grandfather had a friend whose name was Ken. He comes to the state to study. He was so good out there.
Yeah, I was telling someone to write. Did you know that? So, literally, that's his stage name, Kenny Beers. His grandfather went by the same name, so it's like a thing with him. Did you know he was an actress? He's an athlete. He got NCIS. He's a kid on all this stuff. He's done independent films and stuff like that. Pretty funny. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
One of those Sundays after that, he was cool. Also, in Willis K, he takes like 2 or 3 years to get saved. And he came back to go
town. Well.
Well, I was like, how'd you get into acting? He goes, likes parties.
He's so there.
His wife is like, that's all I'm trying to get out of his life. And she's just like, he's an idiot. He's actually not a bad actor, though. He's actually pretty good at it. I guess he's supposed to be down there on like Tuesday. Monday or Tuesday.
Yeah,
you do the whole inventory thing.
Yeah, so November 12th, December 11th.
It'd be cool if we can get some fuel. Uh-huh. Yeah, we'll see how that works out.
Tom said he's on
the list. Or if you
thought he was going to
do it.
Tom said what you said. Everything's a part of that guy, you know, just in general.
His standards are that phenomenal.
Yeah, he's very, he's very bougie.
You didn't know that? I thought you had it on there as a joke.
No, I had it all there. We looked about water.
International Day at school. And so Amber kind of saw the whole thing. But they had students from Canada, Peru, Guatemala, UAE. It was pretty good though. But yeah, we had to provide a lot of things in the
science. It's good for, I don't know. I personally,
all politics.
That's
funny, I told Amber I should have got a camera for that. She found out he had like at home for him. No, he had like pallets
of these things.
It is his.
Oh,
like where he left his home. And so he had like thousands of dollars worth of these things, and he got married, and he wanted to bring like some of them home, but he didn't want to bring all of them. So he didn't want to like tell her. He didn't want her to know the whole step. I guess put that out. And he's like, no, seriously, he's so into the cigar scene that like, he had friends that was like, hey, I got a line on, this guy who's getting a shipment of these, and, you know, if you want like 10 or 20 boxes of them or whatever, And he would do it, and he like seriously had, I'm not joking, $10,000 of cigars. And he had lots of crates, and he actually, before he left, he had to teach his parents how to take care of him. So he had these like totes, you know, and they would put like little distilled water bottles and stuff, so it would like
have people in there.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, my wife's uncle was really into cigars, and then when they opened up the cruise ship going into Havana, Cuba, he took like three trips in that. Had a third trip, he had photos like inside the factory doing tours.
And then should I just call back?
Like we just take off of them and like they still know them like the shit is out all the time. So now like backdoor deals with directly with like the owner of the cigar shop. Like, down there. Like,
And then what do you
I didn't really like it.
Some champagne or something, you know, like, okay. Like a really expensive one, and it's just not good. You know, I do it. I'm just kidding. You know, I'm not like, I can get it. No, he's not. He's super good. We're all sitting out by the fire every time we get time. And then she had had but she picks me out of the crowd. Like, I didn't bring anything up.
I didn't bring the top.
No, I was like in front of everybody.
I'm gonna test it.
And yeah, she picked me out of the crowd and she was just like sort of packing. And I was like, well, I mean, again, I'm not that person either that will just kind of like not talking about it. If you bring it up, I'm like, oh, okay, you want to talk about it? All right, fair enough.
Yeah.
You know, so I was like, well, you know, in my opinion, in my opinion, the decision not necessarily that was because in my entire lifetime, I'd probably prosecute if it wasn't for that precedent, yeah. Right? Yeah. That's the way I felt about it. And she just went off. She called me. She
just, yeah, it was bad.
Well, you know what the funny thing was too? Like, she didn't even know how to respond. I was like, man, you don't know me that well. I was like, my grandmother fled on some time. How I'm here right now is my grandmother and her brother had to leave that country because of what was happening during the 40s, 30s and 40s, you know? Like, she didn't know how to respond to that, but I was just going, she probably wants to stop watching the news. That's what I told her. Just stop watching the news. Pick up a break, you know.
What's that? Did you see the news online? The whole,
It is. It's weird. It's a weird culture we're in, you know, in the West. It's not just us. It's the West in general. It's crazy. I don't like it. Yeah. But afterwards, so I don't know. A few days went by. Apparently, she felt bad. And I saw her probably a couple days later. I think it was Logan's kid's birthday. I saw her. She was like, I'm really sorry. I was like, thanks, bud. That's cool. And then we actually, like, I started talking. I was like, you know what would be cool? I was like, start a book club. I said, like, you give me a book to read, I'll give you a book. Because I guarantee you have some books to do. Maybe you'll understand kind of how I think more. You know, I'm like, I'm a huge student of Thomas Sowell. And Thomas Sowell is like one of the great thinkers of the last century. I'm like, have you ever read any Thomas Sowell? She goes, no, I haven't read any. Give him a try. You know, and then she's like, okay. And I'm like, I'm thinking, like, all right, I'm ready to do Robin Hood or even Mexican. But I'm like, that's fine. But we actually get along really well. She's a great person. She's very radically political. Yeah. Which, I mean, it's a good thing. Like,
oh, it's a good thing. It's a good thing.
Yeah, I really love Kevin. He was probably the most solid OC I've ever met in my career. Really, really good.
was just all for, he was all about the coach that played on that for people.
But I definitely think you were also coming out of the pack area.
Yeah, and that's the thing. They were treating the whole
pack. The pack requirements were big.
Yeah.
And so then when they were obviously going to get like, if you could get, make a better solution through the canal and work with it. And they were using the pack area policy in the pack area. So you got to do this before you get the promise. You don't need this. As soon as we get to the inside and that's going to be cool.
No, nobody was lying.
That's very good. Yeah, that was a problem. My first, like, 76 and so when I played my first 3 months of the
show. Oh, it's crazy. Boy, it was top number on the strike team. I thought it was really funny. But in general, like the policy things that were coming out with, because I was like, all right, so you guys are red mask, it broke up into teams, so every third day you come in, all that kind of stuff. And I was like, all right, let me just tell you this. You think it's going to be about a year before we get vaccinated, right? About a year, and, like, at best. I was like, so my wife's an RN. She works in the ER in the hospital. I work on an international day, and I have 3 kids. And they go to daycare and school. I might as well just start looking going on. There's no way I'm avoiding this state. So, New Jersey at the time was the worst state in the country.
Yeah, they called it that.
I'm at 25 minutes.